TV Joshua Biography, The Synagogue, Healings and Miracles. Temitope Balogun Joshua, 12 June 1963 5 June 2021 was a Nigerian charismatic pastor, televangelist, and philanthropist. He was the leader and founder of the Synagogue, Church of All Nations, SCOAN, a Christian megachurch that runs the Emmanuel TV television station from Lagos. He was one of Nigeria's millionaire church pastors who fly private jets. Joshua was known for his popularity across Africa and Latin America, and his social media presence with 3,500,000 fans on Facebook. His YouTube channel, Emmanuel TV, had over 1 million YouTube subscribers, and was the world's most viewed Christian ministry on the platform before it was suspended. He was described as the Oprah of evangelism and YouTube's most popular pastor. He was awarded various accolades, notably receiving the Officer of the Order of the Federal Republic OFR by the Nigerian government in 2008, and being voted the Yoruba Man of the Decade by pan-Yoruba media outlet Orohinajua. He was called one of Africa's 50 most influential people by pan-African magazines The Africa Report and New African Magazine. As of 2011, according to Forbes, Joshua was Nigeria's third richest pastor, although the claim was immediately denied in a statement by the church. He was known to be controversial, and was even blacklisted by the government of Cameroon in 2010. Biography. According to Joshua's official biography, unusual circumstances surrounded his birth. He said that he spent 15 months in his mother's womb, and narrowly avoided death after a quarry explosion near his house, sent rocks through its roof just 7 days after his birth. It is also alleged that Joshua's birth was prophesied 100 years prior. Joshua, then known as Balogun Francis, attended St. Stephen's Anglican Primary School in Arjidi Akoko, Nigeria, between 1971 and 1977, but failed to complete 1 year of secondary school education. In school, he was known as Small Pastor because of his love for the Bible. He worked in various casual jobs after his schooling had ended, including carrying chicken waste at a poultry farm. He organized Bible studies for local children and attended evening school during this period. Joshua attempted to join the Nigerian military, but was thwarted due to a train breakdown that left him stranded en route to the military academy. He died on 5 June in his home in Lagos shortly after his Saturday night teaching. The Synagogue, Church of All Nations SCOAN. Joshua wrote that in a heavenly vision he had received divine anointing and a covenant from God to start his ministry. Following this, Joshua founded the ministry organization known as the Synagogue, Church of All Nations SCOAN. According to the organization, more than 15,000 members attend its weekly Sunday service. Visitors from outside Nigeria are accommodated in the accommodation blocks constructed at the church. The Guardian reported that the SCOAN attracts more weekly attendees than the combined number of visitors to Buckingham Palace and the Tower of London. The SCOAN's popular services have also resulted in an enormous boost for local businesses and hoteliers. Despite Joshua's popularity, the church has only a branch in Ghana, Joshua stating that it is not yet time for him to have branches worldwide as it will be too much for my character. Religious tourism. The SCOAN has been described as Nigeria's biggest tourist attraction and the most visited destination by religious tourists in West Africa, with thousands of foreigners flocking to attend the church's weekly services. Figures released by the Nigerian Immigration Service indicated that 6 out of every 10 foreign travelers coming into Nigeria are bound for the SCOAN, a fact discussed in Zimbabwean Parliament when addressing the economic potentials of religious tourism. This day newspapers reported that about 2 million local and inbound tourists visit the SCOAN annually. The church's popularity has led to an increase in flight routes to Lagos from several African countries in 2013. Purported healings and miracles. SCOAN claims regular occurrences of divine miracles. Several hundred Nigerians and international visitors come to the SCOAN each week to register for the prayer lines, where the visitors are prayed over by Joshua. SCOAN has published numerous videos claiming to document the healing of incurable disabilities and illnesses such as HIV/AIDS, blindness and open wounds. Spiritual healing at the SCOAN has been the subject of several media reports, including a mention in Time magazine, an Associated Press interview and an article by Foreign Policy detailing the tendency of Nigerians to seek spiritual help due to insufficient medical facilities. a huge debate was stirred within Nigeria when the father of abducted schoolgirl Isamururu stated his intention to take his daughter to TB Joshua for prayers following her release. Similarly, a leaked report stating the intention of Nigeria's embattled former petroleum minister Diasani Alison Maduiki to visit Joshua for spiritual support in her battle against breast cancer elicited controversy.